rubbing off the stove. We're in the kitchen. This is before we've done the counters. As you can see, we've came in and we've taken the spots that have been burned and chipped, and the edges that weren't really nice, we've taken those and sanded them down. Took the edges. You can see before the kitchen. Here's where we've had to straighten it out and sand it back all the way around the corner. So I'll back off, give you a full view of the kitchen before. That's before. And then we'll give you an after. Till then. We're at our first coat of 123 primer. This primer sticks to anything and everything according to the can. So that's our first coat for now. But you can see how much it's changing the looks of the kitchen already. Isn't that
awesome?
Now you can see we're at the second part of it, where we're actually putting on the stone paint. Get a nice close look at it. This is the first coat of it. We have two different colors we're putting on there, actually three. So we'll come back in a minute and we'll show you the next part of it in the cabin that we're doing a countertop on. You want just splotches of green here and there. And you can bounce back and forth with these colors, just kind of come up with your own. Or you kind of got your green a little dark in places, come back in and kind of throw some of this different color on it. Kind of make it blend in. Going back in with charcoal sand. Yeah, just a little charcoal sand to kind of break up the green just a little bit. Make it kind of blend. Don't put a lot on it. Just where you got your spots where the green is just too much in one spot, you can kind of break it up with this. You can see how it's just kind of floating down onto it. So the next step we're doing here is actually, it's called Marble Effect by Montana Paint. And this stuff, you literally just kind of blow it out there and let it fall where it's at. Gives it a granite effect. Falls over the edge, that way it looks like it's continuing. You just want to throw it out.
Voila.
So it's 50-50. You got epoxy resin part A and part B. You mix them 50-50. You want to stir this until you get a really good mix. Once you think you've stirred it good enough, stir it for another minute or so. That way you don't end up with any sticky spots in it. Mice got to break that tension. It's like water tension. Break that. Don't break it. It won't flow. See how it won't, the tension right there? Doing now is you're just spreading out the epoxy resin. Start from the center, work your way out. Try not to push it over the edge until you get a nice even coat of it. And this stuff is self-leveling. Push it where you need it.
One more
At the other end of this almost. Now you will get to see what the epoxy resin done. This is the countertop. It now looks like light green marble countertop. I'll back up and you'll be able to see what it looks like on the whole thing. Isn't that beautiful?